after Wednesday's release of an interim Inspector General report. We now know that VA has a systemic, totally unacceptable lack of integrity within some of our veterans' health facilities. That breach of trust involved the tracking of patient wait times for appointments. Our initial findings of our ongoing internal review of other large VA healthcare facilities also show that to be true. That breach of integrity is irresponsible, it is indefensible and unacceptable to me. I said when this situation began weeks to months ago that I thought the problem was limited and isolated because I believe that. I no longer believe it. It is systemic. I was too trusting of some, and I accepted as accurate reports that I now know to have been misleading with regard to patient wait times. I can't explain the lack of integrity among some of the leaders of our healthcare facilities. This is something I rarely encountered during 38 years in uniform. And so I will not defend it because it is indefensible. But I can take responsibility for it, and I do. So given the facts I now know, I apologize as the senior leader of the Department of Veterans Affairs. I extend that apology to the people whom I care most deeply about, and that's the veterans of this great country, to their families and loved ones whom I have been honored to serve for over 5 years now. It's a call of a lifetime. I also offer that apology to members of Congress who have supported me, to veteran service organizations who have been my partners for 5 years, and to the American people. All of them deserve better from their VA. But I also know this, that leadership and integrity problems can and must be fixed. And so I'm just announcing that I'm taking the following actions. I've initiated the process for the removal of the senior leaders at the Phoenix VA Medical Center. We will use all authority at our disposal to enforce accountability among senior leaders who are found to have instigated or tolerated dishonorable or irresponsible scheduling practices at VA healthcare facilities. I've also directed that no VHA senior executive will receive any type of performance award for 2014, this year. I've directed that patient wait times be deleted from VHA employees' evaluation reports as a measure of their success. We are contacting each of the 1,700 veterans in Phoenix waiting for appointments to bring them the care they need and deserve. And we will continue to accelerate access to care for veterans nationwide who need it, utilizing care both in and outside of VA.